didn't really fit in at the music school. Was it the books I was reading? Was it the purple mini skirt? As I said, it was very, very serious. It was all shh, shh, very particular. And we had these Thursday lunchtime concerts. These were huge events in our lives. Repertoire was chosen, you know, weeks of practice, and the day would dawn where your name was on the program. And I remember one particular Thursday lunchtime concert going out to Bösendorfer piano and needing to raise the lid on it, which one does with one's back to the audience in a purple mini skirt. This new bohemian scene that I was in, I met actors, writers, activists, poets, stilt walkers, fire blowers. I loved it. And I became a founder member for a theatre group called Red Mole. I became the musical director for Red Mole. We were going to revolutionise New Zealand theatre. This club that we ran it out of, which was a strip joint called Carmen's Balcony, it was up, you know, upstairs. I mean, that club was downright illegal. The backstage area was just crazy. It really was big enough for two transsexual strippers. And there were 16 of us out there, no toilet backstage. There were jars. some of the things I did and the outfits I wore, for instance, I had one which comprised beer cans that had been flattened on the road, to which had been soldered jack plugs here, and soldered onto chains that went around the neck. I wore nothing underneath the outfit at the top, didn't have trousers on. It was actually quite painful to wear. Well, my mother Tui and my father Ed came along to the Red Mole Cabaret. This particular night that I was wearing my beer cans, and they came afterwards, worse still, to this ghastly little backstage green room, and I was still standing there in my beer cans, and I said to my father, "So what did you think, Da?" And he said, "You play the piano real good, love." A documentary filmmaker happened to come along to see one of the shows and fell in love with Red Mole. And when we did a little tour, he came on the road with us and made a film called Red Mole on the Road. And I think you do know this person. His name is Sam Neill. Sam was actually a documentary filmmaker for the New Zealand Film Unit at that time, and Sam has always wanted to be, yes, a piano player. So we connected, and he was making another film at the time and asked me to write the music for that. So unwittingly launched me into decades, right up to now, of writing music for films.
It's so quiet when you're not around.
there's no life aboard. Showing me something you've just found. You're the Kung Fu Dragon. I'm a beautiful princess. With your sword you protect me. Come my distress. You're my little friend. My father didn't quite see it like that. He came across the Tasman at that time and he was very worried. I'd moved into this dilapidated stable, the most marvellous building and location, which has all been renovated and where I still live, in Sydney's inner west. But anyway, it was very, very rough. And there I was with this baby on my own and no family. And he went back to New Zealand and he said to my mother, "The poor little buggers living in a shed. We've got to bring her home, Mum." To which my mother Tui replied, "We can't bring her home, Ed. She's 40.
Stay.
stolen from a supermarket in broad daylight. Sleep with two different men on consecutive nights. I can climb a ladder like a monkey up a tree. And I know the same route from 103. And sexually attractive, I can sing a tune at a party on my own. I know how to work the room. I'm scared of